That's actually a part of Easter 2012. We keep working ahead, but that's not what we're going to look at today. First of all, welcome to the Word Music new digital reading session. Kind of a cool idea, huh? We're going to look at Christmas. I got the privilege of working with Wally. Well, I call him Wally, but his official printed name is Walter Black. Wrote a great script called Searching for the King. This is a dramatic musical, so it has two casts, only three people in each cast, and two different stories going on at the same time. It's about 60 minutes long. But before I get into the stories and what's going on with that, because it was called Searching for a King, I took the great worship chorus, Hail to the King. Then I went through the Christmas carols and I found every line I could find about the newborn king and created a new song with those called Glory to the Newborn King. Here's the opening. I mentioned that there were two separate stories, and the amazing thing about the two separate stories is they take place 2,000 years apart. They take place in the same geographical location in the Middle East, in the desert. One takes place in biblical times with just one of the wise men, Melchior, and his apprentice, Mordecai. That's one of the stories. And the other one takes place current day. It's a time of war. And a soldier named Benjamin, this is going to be his story. Now, Mordecai, as we talked about, the apprentice over here and this soldier over here are both looking up at the same starry skies and asking questions. Mordecai is wondering, what is this about this star I'm seeing? What does the future hold? Why are we going to follow this? What are we going to find? And Benjamin's asking why things have happened in his life. Why is this going on in this war? What are the situations? So this is one of the songs in a musical we use to set up the story and ask a lot of questions so we can resolve it. So here's the first song like that, Searching for a King.
Searching for a clue.
this next scene, Benjamin is talking to a friend of his out in the desert and just discussing some deep questions about what's going on in their situation. But the deepest question is why. They have lost their friend Kenny 3 months ago in an accident over there in the war. And Benjamin just has the burning question is, I'm going to be going home on leave right before Christmas. What in the world am I ever going to say to Kenny's mom when I see her for the first time? And I love this last line of this scene. Benjamin goes, look at this place. Hot, dry, dusty. I'm not sure there's ever been any hope here. And that just takes us into a Morning Star song, which is a song of prophecy, which goes back 2,000 years about the long-awaited Messiah. When I'm writing Easter musicals, they're so easy to create because the highest point we have is Hosanna, to the lowest point we have, which is the death, to the highest point, which is the resurrection. Christmas is completely different. The high point we usually have is the big angel announcement. It's always a loud, fast, rhythmic song. This is completely different than I've ever done. This is a beautiful song called It Was a Starry Night, It Was a Holy Night. And I think that's because the writer was trying to show God doesn't do things the same way we do. He had lowly shepherds on a hillside on a quiet starry night, and it changed the world.
With simplicity. It should be no surprise. Shepherds were chosen to hear the mystery of the ages, now revealed in a manger in Bethlehem.
Well, Benjamin is home on leave, and he's with Mrs. Carlisle, Kenny's mom, and they're just having a very deep, meaningful talk about what has happened over the last 3 months. And I just remember this moment in the session. I was sitting in the booth, and the two actors were doing the scene, and I remember being overwhelmed with tears at what was being discussed in the scene. And kind of embarrassed trying to hide that until I looked at the engineer next to me who was also trying to hide his tears. And As the scene finished, the director out on the floor, Amy Byram, made the statement, "I hope you got that, because we ain't doing it again." It was really a tender moment to look at, so you guys really need to listen to that scene and how that was put together. But we reflect that over to Mary and Joseph next. Their life was full of unanswered questions and things they were wondering about. And there's a great lyric here. The next song is called "This Is God." Just listen to this verse. "He looks into the eyes of the mother he created. Mary holds her tiny son with hands that he has formed. And the love she feels so deep is a love he's placed within her. She knows more than anyone, this child who's just been born. This is God."
He looks into the eyes of the mother he created. Mary holds her tiny son with hands that he has formed.
And the love she feels so deep is a love he's placed inside her. She knows more than anyone, the child who's just been born. This is God.
This is God.
This is God.
Wonder of wonders.
This is God.
This is God. He cries out in the night with a voice that spoke creation. He looks up at the stars. He himself once set in
every breath his mother breathes is a breath that he has given. She's humbled as his little hands reach up to touch her face. This is God.
This was an interesting take on a scene I've never thought about before. When the wise men came in to see King Herod, they asked, "Where is he that is born the king of the Jews?" Imagine asking a very insecure, paranoid king where the real king is going to be born. So this scene is played very interesting as they walk away from King Herod and have the discussion as to, you know, he's beheaded three of his children and his wife for asking questions. I mean, we just went in and asked where the king was. And I thought it was so interesting. One of the wise men says, "But he asked that we would find him so he would come, so he could come and worship him also." And Mordecai simply says, "He didn't look like the worshiping type to me." It's a really well-written scene that Wally has put together. And this soars us into two worship songs, which the congregation gets to sing, "Beautiful One," and "Sing, Sing, Sing." Well, in this reprise of Searching for the King, the wise men have found their way to the Christ child. And during this song, you will hear the development of that, and you will see the procession as they come to bow and offer their gifts. Now, Mordecai, the apprentice, is standing on the side watching all of this. And this is very important, because in the next scene, we're going to juxtapose this to 2,000 years later, when Benjamin is watching on the side a reenactment of what is happening in a manger. This is called Searching for the King reprise. After the wise men have knelt before the Christ child and given their gifts, there's about a minute of music in which there's a blackout. And during that time, the choir is singing, the lights are on them, but we are filling the manger scene now, 2,000 years later, with children in the exact same positions, almost in the exact same clothing, and then the lights will come up on them, and they sing a great song. I had a privilege of working with Celeste on in a musical 5 years ago, and they really, at Word, wanted us to add adult choir to this also with the children. So this is a children's choir moment, because they love this first verse, and it says, "What will you do with Jesus? What will your answer be? Will you receive him in your heart this Christmas? And then the big question, will you crown him as your king?" Benjamin watches that song and that manger reenactment. He has a pretty pointed dialogue with Mrs. Carlisle, and she tries to explain to him, you remember when you and Kenny used to run races together, relay races, and Kenny would run like the second lap of the race and pass the baton on to you. Now, when he passed the baton on to you, Benjamin, was the race over? No. No, the race was going to continue, even though Kenny was done his part. And she's able to take that analogy to say, Benjamin, are you willing to pick up this baton that Kenny has been running with his faith and his beliefs and wanting to make a difference in the world? Are you willing to make that statement, to make that choice at this time? Benjamin sings an incredible song called In You I'll Find My Peace. But the really poignant moment of this song is there's a DVD that goes along with it, which is going to have a video of the life of Kenny. Listen to In You I Find My Peace.
Love won't compromise. It's a gift.
It's a gift.
It's a sacrifice. so renewed, and my heart released. In you I'll find my peace. Oh, wondrous child.
Well, I can't really leave you there. The wise men have bowed and worshipped. Benjamin is on a path now of finding answers and finding choices in his life and finding a life with Jesus Christ. And we're able to go back to the theme of the musical, The King, with three great songs. Hail to the King, which we kind of taught in the first song. Now we can invite the congregation to join us. Then I took the second verse of one of the carols, Hail, the Newborn Prince of Peace. Then, of course, it had to end with Joy to the World, the Lord has come, let earth receive her King. So we end in a real big moment of worship and praise. That's it. I don't have a bigger ending than that to end a musical, except maybe Easter 2012. Let's see where that goes. Thank you for joining me for the Word Digital reading session, and I hope I'll see you again real soon. God bless you guys and your ministry.